My name is Aaron Lipsky, Fire Chief, City of Milwaukee Fire Department. With me is my Operations Assistant Chief, Dwayne Smoots. Approximately 2 hours ago, an alarm sounding was reported at the facility behind us, Milwaukee Recycles, at 1401 West Mount Vernon. The time of that alarm being dispatched by us was 1:48 p.m. While our initial companies were responding, they received telephone reports that a machine was on fire inside the building. That was at 1:51. At 1:52, our first arriving engine company and ladder company coming out of 7th and Wells was blocked by a train from being able to respond all the way into the scene. That was quickly cleared out, and we had rigs coming from the other direction that were able to get in there in short order. At 1:58, we were able to determine that all of the employees that work here had in fact evacuated. Unfortunately, we have a long and storied history in this facility of fires. It is somewhat the nature of this sort of work in the recycling industry, but thankfully that has trained the individuals that work here, and we've worked a lot with them to get them actively evacuating anytime these sorts of things happen. At 2:14 p.m., a second alarm was struck, bringing about double the complement of that initial structure fire assignment to the scene. And about a half hour later at 2:46, a third alarm, again bringing an increased number of folks to the scene. At present, we have about 75 firefighters from both the Milwaukee and the Wauwatosa Fire Departments working here. And we do not yet have this fire under control. It is an extremely deep-seated fire. There is a lot of machinery involved here. There are open pits inside this building. And it has the potential, and we're seeing that play out right now, of running along chaseways and various conveyored areas from one area to the next. So we are hitting this with our aerial master streams, large hose lines that we took in there on our initial attacks, and we're going to continue to do that. What I'd expect you'd see in the next hour or so, you're going to see us disassembling the exterior skin of this building a bit to allow us better access into some of these recessed areas. I would remind everybody that this is a recycling plant. What I mean to say by that is the value of the recyclable materials in there doesn't even come close to the value that I place on one of my firefighters' lives. So we are going to be going very slow and methodically so as to not get firefighters tipped over on by a sagging bale of refuse and whatnot. This whole thing changes once this is on fire. So we are going to continue in our present posture. I don't expect we're going to need another alarm, but it is just slightly warm, a little bit humid. The firefighters are working their tails off in all this gear. I would expect perhaps just to relieve them. We'll get some companies in later to relieve the ones that have been here the entire time. We have no injuries reported to civilians, no injuries reported to any firefighters. We're very grateful for that. And that's what I have for you.
Chief, can you talk about what's burning and the toxicity of it?
Excellent. So what we have burning is largely things that you would expect people would be recycling. If you think of your recycling bin at home, there are plastic soda bottles, various plastics and rubbers that might find their way into a recycling bin. There's probably ordinary combustibles like paper, cardboard products. And that would be the primary thing. The toxicity of that is a concern. So we do have our hazardous materials teams. You can see the wind is blowing largely from the east to the west here. We do have our hazardous materials teams going and taking some air sampling to the west of here. You can see the 16th Street Viaduct here is hit pretty hard with that first blast of smoke, and then it seems to get a little bit more diffused. But we're going to keep monitoring that. And the ideal circumstance is that in the residential neighborhoods, we're not going to have any real problems.
Right. Is there any concern for people? Should they be shutting the windows in that area?
Yeah, very good. What I'd suggest is absolutely, if you could shut your windows, if you do have air conditioning, run that instead of keeping the windows open. And very, very simply avoid the area west of here if you're traveling on the roadways or out on the ball walk.
Well, the wind's been pretty strong. How far back do you think it's a concern for residents?
Be hard for me to say. I'm going to put it probably near the 27th Street Viaduct. The one thing we have working for us, this is an industrial corridor here, We are geographically in a valley, so it'll push it more down that valley than it will up into the residential neighborhoods on the south and north side.
You mentioned the employees here are absolutely well-versed in the evacuation. I believe you guys were here last year. I know you guys have been here before. Is it frustrating coming back to a place like this to do the same thing kind of over and over again?
We've put an awful lot of time into working with Milwaukee Recycles to install various fire protection methods that would be fast-acting and keep fires very small. It would appear that perhaps a huge chunk of this fire was in an area not protected by those deluges. So this is what we do, is we come here and we put the fires out, but I would much rather we didn't have.
You said there was a machine on fire inside. Any word on what caused that machine to set on fire?
Very difficult to say at this point. I can tell you historically what is happening in these buildings is occasionally a small propane cylinder will get through. They have a very intricate sorting system in there to pull all the different types of materials apart and get them to different areas for processing. Every once in a while, one of these cylinders gets through. If it gets pinched or crushed, you can get a little pop off from that. We did hear when firefighters were inside, initially there were some various things exploding in there. We're not sure what that was. So that could have been a functioning machine part that's overheated as well.
So you mentioned that you'll be taking your time, safety is key for your workers. How long do you expect it'll take for your crews on the scene to get a handle on this?
I can tell you that this is far more advanced than the majority of the fires we have here. And we typically spend several hours here, so I would anticipate we'll be here probably past nightfall tonight.
And the train that was stopped, why was it stopped? Did it have something to do with the fire, or was it separate?
I have no idea.
Okay. Do you know how many people were here when this fire?
I don't, but I know that they typically have between 25 and 35 employees in and around the center.
To dispatch kind of the outside, the exterior of this building, is that, I mean, obviously a smaller house fire, structured fire, we see that a lot. An industrial building like this, is that kind of par for the course? Is it unusual?
Yeah, just the nature of the fact that it's an industrial structure. Firefighters are extremely adept at recognizing clues from the outside of a residential home to guide their way through when they have zero visibility inside of a fire. In this case, you don't have that immediate familiarity with a building construction style, a building type. Thankfully, we have been in here and we've done a ton of training here as well. So our firefighters are fairly familiar. There are horrible spots to be in there with things falling on you in pits and a lot of industrial and mechanical passageways and throughways. Not an excellent situation. So that is less familiar to us.
Had the train not prevented the crews from getting on scene right away, would that not have impacted how quickly
you could help? Yeah, I mean, it's physics. You know, we can't get from here to there. That takes longer. So in this case, I think we had a Southside engine company coming from the south was able to get in there. It'd be difficult for me to approximate that exact delay, but it's a matter of a minute or so. I can't lay that all at the feet of the train company.
Was there any concern at any point of people coming and going from the casino?
Insofar as just if they're traveling.
Like the smoke and stuff.
Yeah, if they're traveling through the smoke, yeah. I would ask people to avoid doing that.